안녕하세요, 여러분. Hello, everyone. In this video, we're gonna look at the particle 나. I assume if you're interested in learning Korean, you might already know what 나 means. 나 is casual, I. This 나 has the same shape, same sound, but it doesn't mean 나, I. But if you think of it, na is the person who make a choice, right? Especially when you are in casual I. In Korean society, when you have to call yourself cha in front of elders, you are not quite free to choose things on your own. Anyway, that's something extra. This na is not a pronoun, I, but it is a particle. It indicates the freedom of choices. If there's noun in front, you use e as the linking part. By the way, do you happen to know who Lina Khan is? When I saw her name, I was thinking maybe I should connect this lesson with her. These days, Koreans do have names starting with dil, but about 20-30 years ago, all Korean words and names especially could not start with dil. They had the sound rule that when dil comes in the beginning of a word, they change dil into iung, the circle-looking letter. So actually in Korea there's girl's name that is Ina, Kim Ina, Jong Ina. Ina is a girl's name in Korea. Anyway, this person's name is Lina Khan. She is working not against Amazon but against Monopoly. She is warning and she's trying to fight against any huge company, one company monopoly in the market. Anyway, if you are interested in learning about her and what she does, you can look her up. Especially Amazon these days, they are becoming bigger and bigger, right? And after all, if nobody stops this giant company, people will lose their freedom of choice. And even the competitors of Amazon had to go through Amazon to sell their items. So anyway, that's a little extra here. If the word before na is not a noun but verb, like to go, to eat, to sleep, all those verbs, actions, verbs, we use go instead of e. Still, freedom of choice. 학교에 어떻게 가요? 학교, school. 어떻게? How? 학교에 어떻게 가요? How do you go to school? 버스나 지하철을 타고 가요. Bus. We tend to say bus rather than bus. Not soft b sound, but strong like double ba. Bus. Bus. 버스나 지하철을 타고 가요. 타고 가요 is a just a coined expression. I want you to remember when you take some transportation to go to somewhere, you use 타고 가요. 타고 가요. 버스나 지하철을 타고 가요. I take bus or the subway. Now, let's practice. 학교 is a place. You can put there any other places, Walmart, Costco, cheap house, department store, 백화점, you name all the places that you know. That place에 어떻게 가요? How do you get to that place? If you look down there, 기차, train, 배, boat. 기차나 배를 타고 가요. 비행기, airplane, 우주선, spaceship. I know it's funny. Who knows in the future? 비행기나 우주선을 타고 가요. 자전거, bicycle. 버스나 자전거를 타고 가요. You got the idea, right? Like in this manner, you can try to make a lot of sentences on your own. 학교에 어떻게 가요? How do you go to school? 걸어서 가거나 버스를 타고 가요. 걸어서 means on foot. 가다, to go, is the verb, right? So we used 가거나, 걸어서 가거나, 버스를 타고 가요. 아침에 뭐 먹어요? 아침, morning time or breakfast, meal. 뭐, what? 아침에 뭐 먹어요? What do you eat for breakfast? What do you eat in the morning? 빵이나 요거트를 먹어요. 빵, bread. Yogurt. Koreans do not have R, so they omitted, removed R. 요거트. Korean word is syllable based. T only cannot be a word and spelled, so we added neutral vowel, 으, 요거트. Again, let's practice making sentences. 아침, morning or breakfast. 점심, lunch or lunch meal. 저녁, evening or dinner. You can select one of these three. As far as the food, I added 사과, apple, 바나나, banana, 고구마, yam or sweet potato, 피자, pizza. I guess. I wonder if some people eat pizza for breakfast. You got the idea how to make sentences. Right? Try to make a lot of sentences, and I suggest you make funny sentences so that will help you remember better, and will make the language learning much more fun, less stressful. One step further, making your sentences. 먹어요. Do you eat? The present tense, 먹었어요, past tense. You added a double 시옷받침 there to make it past. 먹었어요, ate. 먹고 싶어요, desire. 뭐 먹고 싶어요? What do you wanna eat? 뭐 먹을 거예요? Future, sort of future. What's your plan to eat? 뭐 먹을 거예요? 뭐 먹었어요? What did you eat? 뭐 먹고 싶어요? What do you wanna eat? 뭐 먹을 거예요? What are you going to eat? So now you can pause and challenge yourself how many sentences you can make out of this screen. 주말에 뭐 해요? 주말에 뭐 해요? 주말 is weekend. 주중 is weekdays. 뭐, what? 영화 means movie. 드라마 means soap drama. 주말에 뭐 해요? What do you do over the weekend? 영화를 보거나 드라마를 봐요. 보다, to see, to watch the verb, right? 보거나 드라마를 보아요, 봐요. 오전에 뭐 해요? 오전, in the morning. 오후, in the afternoon. 오전에 뭐 해요? What do you do in the morning? 청소하거나 공부해요. 청소하거나 공부해요. I either clean up or I study. Very ideal. 청소하거나 공부해요. 오전에 뭐 해요? What do you do in the morning? I added a lot of verb activities. 자다, to sleep. 먹다, to eat. Let's make a sentence. 오전에 뭐 해요? What do you do in the morning? 자거나 먹어요. I either sleep or eat. 오전에 뭐 해요? What do you do in the morning? 노래하거나 춤춰요. 춤추어요. 춤춰요. 노래하거나 춤춰요. Either sing or dance. 오전에 뭐 해요? What do you do in the morning? 숙제하거나 운동해요. You know how 하다 changes to 해요? 숙제하거나 운동해요. I either do my homework or exercise. 오전에 뭐 해요? What do you do in the morning? 운동하거나 산책해요. Either exercise or take a walk outside. 산책하다. 오전에 뭐 해요? What do you do in the morning? 기도하거나 동생과 놀아요. I either pray or play with my younger siblings. 오후에 뭐 해요? What do you do in the afternoon? 동생과 놀거나 운동해요. I either play with my younger siblings or I exercise. You can make tons of sentences combining these expressions or on your own. And if you want to know how to say something in Korean, feel free to ask in the comment section below.